Hello, this little video introduces you to the different quiz features of LearnThatWord. Once you log in, you are taken to your portal, and the Start Quiz button is right in the middle. You can choose from two quiz versions, with more quiz versions being under development. Spelling Tutor is completely focused on spelling. You hear a word and spell it. This is the preferred mode for the students competing for the National Spelling Bee, for example. Vocabulary Tutor is more challenging, so I will use this setting to introduce the quiz features. I set the number of words for the session in this drop-down. It doesn't matter if a quiz isn't finished because your learning profile is always updated, even during the quiz session. It shows positively in your performance report, however, if you do finish. Start Quiz. The quizzes are built with a distinct pattern and are 100% designed from data in your personal learning profile. First, we show you the words that you or your teacher added to your account. We also call these preferred words, so we show them at the beginning of the quiz. After these have been quizzed, we will review your practice words with you. Sometimes people think the program is not working if they see the same words come back over multiple quiz sessions, but this is exactly what the quiz is designed to do. If a word was entered incorrectly at the first attempt, it is added to your personal practice word list. It is then repeated, quiz after quiz, until you entered it correctly over three quizzes in a row. If a word was added by mistake, for example a typo, it can be removed at the end of the session in which it was added. It is not uncommon with hard words to have many more than three repetitions to get your learning spark awarded. But you will also notice that your brain will soon build word automaticity faster and with less effort. Your brain will learn to learn this type of information, so to speak. After your personalized practice words, the quiz will introduce new words based on your preference settings. Some people feel anxious when being tested. It makes them feel like they need to get everything right. With LearnThatWord, there are no negative consequences attached to making a mistake. Errors simply tell the program that the word needs more review. We purposefully avoid introducing the word before your first exposure in the quiz. Otherwise, it would be hard to tell if the word is really known or just in short-term memory from that introduction. By first testing which words are known and removing those, you focus all your time on working on words that actually need practice. In the vocabulary quiz, the audio buttons for word and sample are hidden in the beginning. Instead, you see the number of letters of the words and can request first and last letter by pressing the blue clue button. After requesting these clues, the audio buttons become available. This icon appears only if a word was added, and if the word list included a custom definition. This content is created by the user who made the word list. We provide a lot of information for you to quickly learn the word. Context sample with audio, a brief definition, an image where appropriate, translations of the word in any 37 languages, tutoring comments, and a lot of additional information. Let's look at what happens when you get something wrong.
All love that has not friendship for its base is like a mansion built upon the sand.
There's a flash of yellow that indicates that this was not the right answer, and you get a second chance. This word has now been placed on your personal practice list, and will be repeated until you have entered it correctly three times in a row over subsequent quizzes. See how we are showing you the letters you got right but removed those that you had problems with? Cognitive neuroscience has found that the brain creates mental orthographic images for every word presented, right or wrong. Showing misspellings is a sure-fine way to confuse the brain. After the second incorrect attempt, we show you the answer. There is just not enough value in guessing. Every time you get a word wrong twice, you will be taken through a hands-on, visually enforced practice cycle to help you store the mental orthographic image faster. The same practice cycle can be triggered voluntarily by clicking on the orange practice button at the bottom right of this answer screen. After you click the practice button, you are shown the word in different colors, letter by letter, and after one last impression, you are challenged to enter it yourself. If you get it right, we move on to the next word. Research in our focus groups has shown that this practice step just about cuts the number of repetitions needed in half. The ABC button on the answer screen speaks the word letter by letter. Oh, I was guessing this word, but I was lucky! Normally, the program will assume that you know this word because you entered it correctly at first attempt. Since I like to feel really secure about the words I use, I will put this word on practice list by myself, just to make sure that I won't have to hesitate next time I want to write it. I do this by clicking on these two-way arrows to the left of the next button. This will add the word to the practice list. Okay, one more word. The image says it all. Fig. Since I entered this word correctly before clicking the Hear Word or Example Audio button, I was given a bonus point, as documented down here. I will use this last word to show you the buttons on the right side of the answer screen. Here is the practice button I mentioned. It will trigger the practice cycle for this word. Above are links to 4 online resources directly linked to the word you just studied. ThinkMap is an interesting online thesaurus that displays the relationship between words visually. You'll need to click these 2 buttons unless you already purchased this program, which is offered by a third-party website. Look, isn't it fun? It's like moving through a cloud of words. The second button links to Answers.com, a long-term partner of our nonprofit. Answers list information from a large range of resources on one page, so you can see what all kinds of different resources have to say about figs. Here, for example, are videos on how to prepare desserts with figs. The third button is Merriam-Webster. And lastly, the people-edited Wikipedia website with a ton of advertisement-free content about figs. Okay, we're about to wrap up our quiz demo. Just one more button that is really important. If you have feedback, let's say you have an image for a word, or a good context sample or tutoring comment, notice a typo, or would like to suggest re-recording a word, please click the comment button and send us a message. We're committed to constantly upgrade and expand this offering. Your feedback helps us improve this resource.